continue along the other yellow wall with three ink drawings. Do you see number three with all the hash marks and symbols? Look at all those creases. It seems to have been folded and folded and folded into a little package.
So this is a powwow formula. In German, they called it Brauerei, or healing.
Lisa Minardi is a decorative arts historian who studies Pennsylvania German art and artifacts.
Was somebody sick? Had there been some kind of tragedy? You know, did their neighbor's barn burn down or something? And, you know, here they are seeking help.
This piece of paper asking for healing or protection, it may have been tucked inside the wall of a barn.
At the bottom, it's referring to the 12, like, here underwritten signs. So then there's all of these different symbols and numerals that are down there, but I do not know what those symbols mean.
Of course, I don't know what they mean either. Somehow, it all manages to speak. Muffled, though. Like listening through a keyhole. Move to the right, to number four. A tiny, tiny ink drawing on blue-lined paper. A spray of leaves and flowers. When I saw this downstairs in the flat files, I knew right away I had to have it. What does that even mean, to have it? It's not mine. But maybe while we're looking at it, for now, it's ours. Lisa Minardi thinks it was tucked inside a book for a few generations. That's how it survived.
Probably done by a schoolmaster, I would guess, for one of his pupils. Her name is Elizabeth Deal. Then the date, 1845. You know, if you recited the alphabet correctly, you might be given one of these for encouragement.
I'm encouraged that something so tiny and so lovingly rendered was not lost. The large ink drawing at the end of the wall is number five. A self-portrait by Françoise Gillot. She is not tucked inside anything. With those long strokes of ink, I think she decides for herself how she wants to be seen.
She knew what she was doing. She'd done it many times, obviously. She is totally self-possessed.
She is looking beyond us.